Today, I will demonstrate that prompt tuning and prefix tuning are as effective as or even superior to fine tuning. I will also provide you with a PyTorch implementation. By the end of this video, you will have the skills to use both techniques to enhance your own LLM's use case. And if you don't have LLM's knowledge, I will explain it in a way that you still can follow every step of the way. I'm Maryam Miradi, and I have 20 plus years experience in AI, specialized in NLP and lessons learned. Every time that you say, I want to improve my LLMs, what you mean is that you want better outcome, and you can achieve that with model source or interaction with model. Your model could be off the shelf. It means that you just download it and use it. Fine tune it a little bit. It means that you just adjust some parameters, and then you can continue and fine tune it a lot, which is continued pre-training. And a complete pre-training means you just build your LLM from scratch. And why do we call pre-training and fine-tuning? Because building an LLM has two phases, pre-training and fine-tuning. You can also improve the interaction with the model. We know that very well because you're using prompt engineering for a while, and that's actually hard prompting. Today, I'm going to talk about prompt tuning and prefix tuning. And if you have your internal documents, you can just go ahead and use RAG, which is Retrieval-Augmented Generation. For example, an off-the-shelf model, and combine it with soft prompting and get very good result. Or you can pretend your model, meaning that you're building it completely from scratch, and add to it some internal document using RAG. Which of these combination do you need to use for your specific use case? The best strategy is to just treat them as a ladder, meaning that you just start with the simplest and go to the hardest. The same applies to interaction. Just start with the hard prompting, go to prompt tuning, prefix tuning, and finally to RAG, or combine a few of these. It really depends on your use case and what is your goal. Your goal could be, for example, feature extraction or translation or question answering, summarization. Any of these will give you possibilities. Also, there are a lot of models available. As I said before, today I'm gonna focus on prompting and especially the prompt tuning and prefix tuning, and I will show you how these can beat fine tuning. For prompting, you already know hard prompts, prompt engineering. Prompt engineering is the process of manually creating a suitable prompt. It is called also prompt design. When you give a prompt and passing it via an API, to a language model, most of the time you're asking for some kind of creation. And it is important to give some background and context. And we do that with many short prompting. In this case, short means examples. And also we want some clarity and a specificity. And we do that with format, length, and style. And if that's not enough, we can go, for example, to meta prompting. When we ask an AI, act as a prompt engineer and do a task, do it in a markdown way, output it also in a code block. As you can imagine, there are infinite possibilities of right prompts or wrong prompts. But also another problem is prompt drift. It means that you're done with one prompt and then now your prompt is not more suitable. For example, if your prompts are for GPT-4, then GPT-4 all comes and you can start over. Now that we know all of the prompt engineering problems, let's take a look at the soft prompts. And we start with the prompt tuning. In the prompt tuning, we can go ahead and look at what's happening actually in that prompt embed layer, which will be added to our text embedding layer. If, for example, we have a sentence, San Francisco has a higher number of AI companies compared to New York, then next to that, we will add some random numbers, which is our prompt embedding layer. Let's compare it with fine tuning. In fine tuning, you will give that example to the text embedding layer, and the model itself will be actually updated. But in the prompt tuning, you never touch the model. The model is completely locked. And what you do is, basically update that prompt embedding layer. What's inside that prompt embedding layer? There are completely random numbers. There are virtual tokens. And these virtual tokens, basically they are not any language that you know. Let's take a look at implementation of this in PyTorch. It is super simple. You basically create an embedding layer, which is randomly created, and then you concatenate it to your existing input. The research shows that These soft prompts are basically better than inform understandable prompt. But how is it possible that these completely random texts are better than the language, you know, the understandable English that we will talk about? The reason that is that large language model does not understand facts or words, but they work with the embeddings of those words, so the numbers. And if you create something of a number which is close to those understandable or optimal prompts, then you basically improve your large language models with the prompts that are generated completely automatic and are not prone to the mistakes of a human being. Before proceeding to the next topic, I have a free guide for you, which is the compression of all my 20 plus years of experience in data science. If you're interested, just type free data science guide in the comment and I will send it to you. Let's continue. This graph shows how great actually the prompt tuning will do. And it is based on the superglue score. If you don't know what is a superglue score, it's a combination of Boolean questions and reading comprehensions and textual entailments and wording context and challenges, schema challenges. So basically a lot of good tests for the LLM. And if you look at this result, what we can see is that the red and orange are the model tuning and model tuning, which is fine tuning and with the multitask. And the green one is prompt tuning and blue one is the prompt design or prompt engineering. We can see that if the model is small, then we basically have better results with fine tuning. But as soon as our model become a little bit bigger, the number of parameters is higher, then the prompt tuning is the same as fine tuning, which this is really great. Now let's take a look at prefix tuning. Prefix tuning is basically prompt tuning. The only difference is that you don't add embedding layers only to the input layer, but you also add it to all of the transformer's hidden layers. So in this way, you stack more and more of those embedding layer. And that's why prefix tuning has even better results than prompt tuning. And if you compare it with the fine tuning in this picture, you can see that in the fine tuning, you change the whole layers, where in the prefix tuning, you only change those embedding layers. Let's take a look at its code implementation in PyTorch, very comparable to prompt tuning. You will create your embedding layer. The difference here is that you add that created, completely randomly created embedding to all of the layers inside your neural network. That's basically the only difference. The researchers of Stanford University, they have a very great GitHub with implementation of prompt tuning and prefix tuning. I will add the link in the description so you can use that and you don't need to implement actually that yourself. You can play around with that one. The research of Stanford University also showed that prefix tuning do a better job than fine tuning, as you can see in this comparison. So as we have seen, prefix tuning and prompt tuning are great. In the coming videos, I will talk about DSPy, Langchain, Langgraph, and Langsmith. And also I will dive into other things in this ladder, for example, Retrieval-Augmented Generation or pre-training or fine-tuning. In the first video of this series, I have done also sentiment analysis and fine-tuning. So if you're interested, watch that one. I'll see you there.